predictability. The milkman, the paper boy, the evening TV.
Good morning, Central Crossing, and welcome to Friday. I'm Jesse.
And I'm Zach.
So we got a little bit of snow yesterday.
Yeah, unfortunately, not enough to have fun in. But let's see if there's more in the forecast. What can you tell us, weather?
Good morning, Central. I'm Jade.
And I'm Chance.
And here's the weather for today.
Today there will be a high of 34 degrees with a low of 24 degrees. But on the bright side, there's no snow. Just the sun not heating up the earth.
Good point, but at least there's only 18 more days until spring starts, so a warm-up is almost guaranteed to come soon.
True. So what's for lunch today?
Well, today we'll be having breaded cheese sticks, a deli sub with Keebler snack, or a chicken and waffles with oven potatoes.
Sounds pretty good.
That's all from us.
Thank you, guys.
So it's Friday, which means it's Smoothie King Day. The school store has so much more to offer. Take a look.
Stop by the school store today during your lunch.
Next up, we have some deadline reminders.
Seniors, please remember to be regularly checking the scholarship list in Naviance. New scholarships are added regularly. Click on the college tab and then on the scholarship tab. You must come to the school counseling office and request scholarship transcriptions. Do not request transcriptions for scholarships via Naviance. Please also remember that the Southwestern City Schools Education Foundation scholarship is due by midnight today.
And then for you sophomores, the Innovation and Entrepreneurship Program has very limited spots available, but will be accepting applications through Tuesday next week. If you're interested in a career in the business or marketing field, or want to become a part of DECA, and want to learn how to be a successful professional, you should consider applying. If you are interested, see Mrs. Killeran or Mr. Todd in the school store for information on how to apply. On Wednesday, we will fill the final spots.
And if you are interested in taking college classes for free next year, follow these steps.
Step 1.
Talk to your school counselor ASAP.
Step 2.
Apply to Columbus State. Directions are available in the guidance office.
Step 3.
Fill out the CCP interest survey. This must be done in order for you to be properly tested for potential College Credit Plus courses. The survey is on the homepage of the CCHS website and on the homepage of Naviance Family Connections. Step up the CCP paperwork. The intent to participate in Columbus State Community College consent forms are available in the guidance office. Pick them up ASAP.
You must apply and fill out the survey by March 3rd to be tested at CCHS at the end of the March.
Next, we have news that you've been waiting for.
First, spring break is on its way, only 3 weeks away.
And that means Comet Olympics is coming. Comet Olympics is Friday, March 24th. As a reminder, each class needs its own color t-shirts. Freshmen are gray, sophomores are Comet blue, juniors are black, and seniors are white.
Seniors t-shirts are in the works, and senior student council members are selling their Comet Olympics t-shirts through Thursday, March 9th. T-shirts are only $7, and if you would like a name on the back of your shirt, add $5. Please see the following seniors to purchase:
Elijah Ferguson, Carson Young, Chastity Gibson, Olivia Terrell, Blake Hancher, or Richmond Salonga.
Payment must be received in cash when ordering. T-shirts will be available for pickup the day before Comet Olympics.
And now in club news.
Today we have GSA in Mr. Osborne's room.
And then CISA Puente has a meeting next Tuesday during the sixth period. Please plan to check in with your sixth period teacher before going to the meeting.
Also meeting next Wednesday is our new chess club. All chess players are invited to play a game or two of chess after school next Friday. Plan to meet in room 209. We have plenty of chess sets, or you can bring your own.
Now let's head to the locker room for sports.
No more message across, and I'm Ethan.
I'm Wolfgang.
And here's sports.
First, we want to send out congrats to Jake Kaiser for his recent signing to Urbana University to play football. Jake was an all-OCC and all-district O-lineman at CCHS and a part of 16 wins as a three-year starter.
Also, congrats to Drew Carmichael for his recent signing at Moorhead State University. Drew holds school records in points as the kicker, field goals made, and longest field goal. Drew was an all-league kicker in 2015 and an all-league punter in 2016.
And then we want to wish the wrestlers luck today as they compete in the district tournament today and tomorrow at Hilliard Darby. The top four districts will move on to the state tournament next week at the Schottenstein Center. Last week, the Comets finished third at their sectional tournament, placing 10 wrestlers with 6 wrestlers moving on to districts with 3 alternates.
5 wrestlers claimed sectional titles last week was Zach Collins, Hudson Leapley, Devin Wood, Ryan Fay, and Jaden Maddox, each winning their weight class. Bobby Logan plays second, Austin Vasquez, Noah Ross, and Aaron Reasoner plays fifth, and will be district alternates. Mason Moore is plays sixth for the Comets. Good job, Comets.
Also competing this weekend is senior Julius Swallows, who will be representing Central Crossing in the pole vault in the state indoor track and field championships at the University of Akron on Saturday morning. Julia, our school record holder, comes in ranked 12th, but has an excellent opportunity to make it onto the podium.
And then our boys basketball team is headed to districts. They play Davidson tonight. Tip-off is at 7 p.m. With the win this Friday, we'll play Westerville South next Friday, and that will be the first tournament win in Central Crossing history. For the season, we were 10-12, and we're really hoping for a win tomorrow. That's all for today.
Back to you, anchors.
Thanks.
In addition to our athletes competing this weekend, we also have band and choir competing at the OMEAs today. They are headed to Thomas Worthington, so good luck, band and choir.
We're in that.
We are in that.
Now here is Gavin and Mackenzie with information on the Arnold Classics, which is going on this weekend.
Good morning, Central Crossing. I'm Mackenzie.
And I'm Gavin.
And we're here to talk about the Arnold Classic that's here in Columbus and started yesterday.
The IFBB Arnold Sports Festival, also known as the Arnold Schwarzenegger Sports Festival, is an annual multi-sport event consisting of professional bodybuilding, strongman, fitness, figure, and bikini weekend expo.
It was established in 1989 and named after Arnold Schwarzenegger. The main event is held annually around late February, early March in Columbus, Ohio.
It is the second most prestigious event in professional men's bodybuilding, physique, and figure.
Times to go are tomorrow from 9 to 5:30 and Sunday from 10 to 4.
It is something interesting. You should check it out.
I go every year. It's so fun.
That's it from us.
Back to you, anchors.
Thank you, guys. I went last year and had a lot of fun. I totally did.
Did you really?
Well, that is it for today.
Have a great Friday.
And a fun and safe weekend.
See you Monday, Central.